Since Cyberpunk 2077's launch on consoles, people have been waiting to see how it fares on older generation platforms. And I have some very early tests to share with you, so this is just my early first impressions and findings. Of course, if you've been on social media, you already know that the base platform struggled to load the proper level of detail for a lot of characters in Night City. And in our Xbox One intro, it doesn't load the proper clothing in early cutscenes when playing as Nomad either. So while we have a larger performance analysis on all platforms, I wanted to share my first frame rate discoveries on the Xbox with PlayStation coming in the near future. Digital Foundry actually just released their PlayStation feature, and it also runs very poorly on PlayStation, so let's get that out of the way. Thus far, we've discovered that, unsurprisingly, the base Xbox platform is in incredibly rough shape. It struggles to hit 30 frames per second at 1080p resolution, and it's dropped as low as 10 frames per second for me during analysis capture, which is just absolutely insane. And it also drops to 20 frames per second even when you're doing simple things like walking outside during the introduction. On all platforms, you can see that the resolution just isn't there. Even on the Xbox Series X, that's because it's still running the Xbox One version of the game. But as you go to older versions, it also fails to trigger special effects like explosions during this car sequence where the car is supposed to hit the wall, explode, and sort of have an exciting moment. It just doesn't happen. And enemies just won't react the way they're supposed to. They won't even shoot at you on some of the older platforms. It's truly bizarre playing on the base Xbox One. Literally, as I was recording this feature, the Cyberpunk team pushed out patch 1.04. It is a hot fix. And it addresses a ton of issues, including performance and stability on consoles, especially that crash fix. For consoles, it's only available on PlayStation. It's also available on PC, but it is not available on the Xbox platform at this time. So this happened while I was doing analysis. So everything in this video is pre 1.04. I was able to analyze the car chase sequence on PlayStation 4 base before and after. I happened to be recording the base platform. And as you can see, it didn't really make that much of a difference. Anyway, let's get back to looking at the Xbox platform. Looking at signs, you can just look at them and the text will take this long in real time to appear. So you would drive by these and you would never see the directions to where you want to go in the world. Some of the base resolutions I was able to calculate, and this is a rough calculation. They're really hard to get because they're doing dynamic scaling all the time. But it's sub 720p on base Xbox One at times. You can tell it's struggling also, as taking out your gun will cause your gun to materialize as the engine renders the geometry of the piece. There will be character models set in a position for some reason that would randomly change. They would just change to a different character model during my gameplay. On base Xbox One, going into an internal location, the game would freeze. The game would freeze when you're doing something as simple as exiting your vehicle. I've seen a lot of people saying crashes are rampant, but I haven't encountered that yet. It will just freeze for a very long time and then continue gameplay. So Xbox Series X fares a lot better than the base platform. It has both quality and performance mode to choose from. Performance mode was struggling to keep 60 frames per second, but it was hovering a lot closer to 50 frames per second while sacrificing quality. Keep in mind, even the PC version struggles with frame rate on this game. So I'm actually not that surprised that it can't hold 60. I really, really want to see the next gen patch to see how it fares once it has all the bells and whistles activated. There's a marked improvement on quality mode on the Xbox Series X. It targets 30 frames per second on the Series X, and it largely stays there. Sometimes it'll dip to like 29, but it's very minor, and it won't really impact your gameplay. Generally speaking, though, even the next-gen platforms, they look soft. The textures are clearly Xbox One textures. And what's really confusing to me is the Series X has a 30 frames per second mode quality and a 60 frames per second performance mode. The PlayStation 5 only has the 60 frames per second mode and no options to adjust to 30. So all of the PlayStation versions are 101.9 gigabytes, while Xbox is 59.3 gigabytes and PC is 59.6 gigabytes, much more manageable. One of the sequences that I used for early frame rate testing was the car chase. It's fairly early on in the game. There's a lot of rain. You're driving through the city. And on Xbox One X, it does not stay steady at 30, it dips below 30, and it struggles to sort of stay there. During gameplay, it didn't dip so much that it totally ruined anything, but it's also not great, if I'm being honest. On the Xbox One X, just doing something as simple as walking out the building, the game, it flutters to like 29 frames per second at time, but largely it stays locked. So it's not having the performance issues of the base Xbox. Even the Xbox Series S manages to stay at 30 frames per second. Things seem to be playing out how they're supposed to. So the game looks really, really good on the Series S. I was really, really happy to see that it's maintaining 30 frames per second. It does not have a 60 frames per second mode at this time. It is only the 30 frames per second mode on the Series S, and it stays there locked. The Xbox Series X handles 30 frames per second just fine. It'll fluctuate between 50 and 60 frames per second on the performance mode, where you're trying to keep that locked 60, which, I mean, it's not great, but after seeing that my high-end PC struggled to keep 60 without DLSS on, I'm actually not that surprised. Yeah, the Series X 60 FPS mode, it doesn't keep a lock 60. It's sort of fluctuating all over the place, dipping as low as 40, but you get a smoother experience at the sacrifice of quality. So it's sort of up to you what you want to do there. 30 frames per second, it is locked, it looks better. Giving a shout out to Digital Foundry again, John Linneman, for example, plays the game at 30 frames per second because you're able to sort of get all the bells and whistles going. And the Series X has no problem running at 30 FPS mode. Everything seems to look great. No glaring issues on the Series X at this setting. But even at performance mode, it does struggle to keep up. So just looking at the Xbox One for a second, I just want to say that I don't think that you should play this game on the base Xbox One. The fact that the frame rate dips to 10 frames per second, it's just, I don't advise it. It is not an enjoyable experience. I streamed a little bit of gameplay last night on the base Xbox One, and people were saying that it was making them nauseous, that because the frame rate was just, it's just all over the place. And the game, it's falling below 720. That's just insane. It's bringing in super low level of detail characters. This is my gameplay going into the bar where the game just froze. It would freeze, sort of catch up, and then start loading in the NPCs. And of course, the main NPCs all look at least decent, I guess you could say. But the ancillary NPCs, they just aren't where they need to be. Anyway, these are my initial findings. Again, usually I script this out and I put together a more elaborate piece, but I wanted to sort of show you guys the gamut of experiences that you can have just on the Xbox platform. Right now, I would recommend you avoid the base Xbox. It's a really, really rough experience. The Xbox One X fares a lot better. The Xbox Series S seems fine and stable, and the Xbox Series X is also largely stable. I recommend playing at the 30 FPS mode. I've seen some people online say, start disabling motion blur, disable chromatic aberration, disable film grain, and you're gonna get a much cleaner looking experience. Those are effects that developers will often add to either be fancy or, to be honest, sort of cover up some of the issues with the game. So it should clean it up. And I've also seen some people do some investigations into the HDR settings on the Xbox, saying you should turn it off because HDR doesn't seem to be functioning properly. So if you are playing with HDR on your Xbox, there's issues there that you might want to do a little bit more investigating into. I know I'm going to. I need to look into that. There's a lot I need to look into to sort of figure out. But this is, again, super early. So I'm going to be diving in a lot more to see if it gets worse or gets better. I hope you found this helpful. This is just the information that I've discovered. So for more on all things Cyberpunk, keep it here at IGN.